I'm Asuna Zenith, doing my first MA Sociology here in Hyderabad University. Yesterday at around 10:30, I got a message, I got a message saying that Appa Rao has taken charge as VC and come to VC lounge as soon as possible. So like our classes got over at 10:45, and the moment we went there, we could see that there were already students from, from the opposition who were in support of Appa Rao inside the VC lounge, and they were bringing out slogans like pro Appa Rao, and they were antagonizing us and provocating us as much as possible. And the police were brought in. The media was inside, but they were not let close to the students to capture whatever was happening. And when we went there, we could see that all the security, the police, everybody, they were protecting the VC. And the VC had given a task list to the administration, asking them to be here at this time in Gachibowli Stadium at 7:30, 8:15, be here in the small gate, and then after 9 o'clock, as the VC takes charge, ask the students from life sciences to come and congratulate the VC and everything. It was a very clearly written task list that the VC had given to the administration, and the administration has passed it on to the non-teaching staff.
In the milk, tea and chairs, like that.
Yeah, and he had also written that to bring 150 chairs and 6 tents, so that people can sit outside and convene the
to
meeting.
To welcome him,
to convene the meeting. There was an emergency EC subcommittee meeting held in VC's lounge. When there is a subcommittee meeting, it is supposed to be happening in the administrative block, and not here in not inside some residential area. If the meeting is happening in a residential area in anybody's house, then that becomes a public space. It does not have the title as residential area. So it is a public space where the EC subcommittee meeting is happening. So when all of us went, we were protesting since morning, and around lunchtime, the workers, the non-teaching staff came, and they also, they were raising slogans pro-VC. They were Appa Rao Zindabad, students Murdabad and everything. And they are, protesting against the students, and in support of VC, they have closed down the mess. Since yesterday afternoon, there is no food in mess. The administration has cut down water, electricity, internet facilities, everything from the campus. Classes have been suspended, and this was going on for a long time in the yesterday afternoon. At around 4:30, the police rounded up the VC lodge, and nobody was let to either go out or come inside. And around 5 o'clock or something, the commissioner of police, he gave a statement that we have been asking you to leave this place for so long, but you're not leaving. So if you're not leaving now, we will start our lathi charge. We will start do our job.
Statement they announced at that
They time? Announced there. But we were not allowed to go outside, nor were people allowed to come inside.
So it was just a formality, actually.
Just a formality, and threatening people. He was literally threatening us, saying that you should go out, you should leave this place as soon as possible. But when we sat, we were protesting. We were like, we won't go as till you arrest the VC, till you, take him back. They started lathi charging us, brutal lathi charge. The male students were brutally attacked. They were four or five policemen were pulling one person. One policeman with one leg, one policeman with hand. They were pulling so badly. The women police, they just slapped the female students. Who are they to slap the students? How can they slap? They have no right to hit anybody. Even during lathi charge, the police do not have any right to hit the students. And one more thing I forgot to mention was, when there is a case filed against a person under the Prevention of SCST Atrocities Act, the perpetrator or the convict is not supposed to get inside the place of place of committing the crime. until and unless he is resolved of the crime. He's not supposed to get inside. So how did he come in? Who let him inside? Where are the police justice? They are asking us to leave when we were protesting in a very democratic manner. We never used any form of violence against the police. Only when they started attacking us, like with the emotional trauma, the students, they could not bear the pain. So they obviously we will retaliate. But even then, we forced the students to not to retaliate because it is a very democratic protest. We can only protest through pens, papers, and raising slogans. We cannot go resort to violence. We cannot resort to violence because we are students. We are progressive students. We will not resort to violence. And how could they resort to violence against us? Yesterday, during the police attack, even when people were leaving the place, telling that, fine, we will evacuate the place. Especially the women police, they hit us. They hit us telling how dare you protest here. And police asked us to evacuate the VC lounge.
It means they were slapping you?
They
or
were
like...
slapping us. They were hitting us on the... Two students were hit on their stomach and they were hospitalized.
Okay, but you were hit by the lady police?
Lady police.
Okay. And lady did the police. Male policemen also hit the female students?
They did not hit as such, but they were abused, were like verbally abused. They verbally abused.
So the male policemen were abusing the female students?
Students. I will come to that. I will tell you. The police asked us to evacuate the VC lounge. That is why they started the brutal lathi charge. Now, we had evacuated the VC lounge. Their job is over.
And what was the reason they are saying to evacuate the VC lodge?
It is a private property. VC's property. We are intruding into the another's place. As soon as we evacuated the, you know, we were pushed out of the VC lounge. We were protesting democratically, we were pushed out of the VC lounge. They were supposed to stop there. Who are they to come into humanities department and arrest people from who are there in humanities department? They arrested a professor who went to ask them, how can you come here and arrest people? They arrested a professor. And when a girl went and asked the police, how can you come, and it was near Gopes. And they were chasing people from VC lounge to near Gopes.
Gopes is food court?
Food court. The food court in Gopes.
The canteen, which is almost, I think, 600 to 800 meters from the VC lounge.
Almost 1 kilometer from the VC lounge. When the girl went and asked the police, how can you arrest people here? How can you beat people here? They said, I literally quote, you're a girl, behave as a girl, or else we will hit you such that they will not be able to recognize that you are dead. They use such abusive languages.
This is told by male policeman.
Male policeman to the female.
To a female student.
Female student. They also said that we will also rape you. If be a girl. How can they tell that? They are policemen. They are supposed to be protecting the public. Police are supposed to protect the victims, the innocent. And they are protecting the criminal there. And he is happily sitting inside. From yesterday, 12 o'clock, there is no internet facilities. And the media is not allowed inside the campus so that we can convey our messages, whatever is happening inside the university, to the outside world. Nobody knows. Like my parents, who are very, generally aware, they have been watching the news, but they did not know this until I called them at around 8 o'clock in the night. They did not know that all these have been happening in the university. And they are people who keep watching the news, who keep looking for updates on all the channels regarding the, world affairs, current affairs. So many of them did not know what is happening. Even now, if you ask them, they don't know. they won't be knowing because the media does not know what to project. And some media which was here also, they have been projecting us in a very negative light. They just told that there was a mild charge and only 5 students have been arrested. But as of there was brutal lathi charge, 36 students including 3 faculties were arrested.
Yesterday.
And today when we came to know that the mess is not going to be working, the students' union tried talking to the mess workers to come to a consensus to start the mess, but they did not agree to it. And so we ourselves took up the charge of making cooking food, and many hostels like we cooked food, and in Shopcom, like in this shopping complex, they wanted to cook food. And these police people, they came and stopped people from cooking here. When they asked a person, he is a senior leader in one of the organizations, when they asked him, when they told him not to cook, he asked like, why should we not cook here in Shopcom? The police attacked him, they arrested him, they brutally beat him, and later they just left him. They didn't even take him to the hospital. They didn't even take him to the health center, which is just here. Now he is very serious and he has been taken to Pranam Hospital. So this is what has been happening now in the campus. And one more misconception is the students, the neutral students who are not part of this protest, they are being told that all these facilities, basic facilities, are being cut down because of the protesters. Like, they are being told that the protesters are cutting down their waters, water facilities, internet facilities, electricity facilities, everything. Today morning we had gone for a room-to-room campaign. In every room, knocking door to door to explain to them what happened yesterday, to tell them how brutally we were attacked. Who are the police? Are they protecting the innocent, or are they protecting the criminal? Who are they supposed to be protecting in reality?
So when you are talking with the students at their rooms, so did they ask any question?
Yes, they asked. Many of them did not know what happened. They did not know what happened in the university yesterday. They were just blank. They just know that internet facilities, water facilities has been cut down. They didn't know why. The classes have also been suspended. And these classes have been suspended because of the VC, as given order by the Vice Chancellor.
And roughly, like, how many policemen were there yesterday?
Roughly around 200.
Okay. And how many students were there?
Students, we were around 50 to 100.
50 to 100.
50 to 100. So it was almost double the amount of students were there.
Okay. So, like, see, but even today, like, the neutral student you mentioned, right? So, do you want to give any message to students? Because still, see, now you see clear cut cutting of the water, food, and because I never heard any administration will do these things to their own students, right? So even for me it is the first time. So but still those students say we are neutral actually. So do you want to say something to those neutral students?
I just want to tell them that in case you have any issues regarding this protest, like in case you have any clarification, if you get any rumor saying that it is the protesters, the students who are protesting doing all these, don't believe them. Come and ask us, those who are part of the protest. Ask us, we will clarify, we will tell you the facts. And we need your support. It is not time to be neutral. It is not time to be apolitical. It is time to take a stand. You cannot be neutral. You have to take a particular stand. You have to do that. take a stand, be with us, be in support of the students.
So yesterday you were also beaten up?
Yes, yes.
So by male policeman and female policeman?
Female
both?
Policeman, I was beaten up, and the male policeman, when we went outside.
Summarize it. Yeah. Summarize it. No problem.
Yeah. So that is what we. This is what I wanted to tell. So to all the students who don't know what is happening, please get to know what is happening in this university. And if you have any issues or clarifications, do come to us and ask us. We are ready to explain everything and take a stand, take a firm stand. Be with us. Support us.